lack, because the things we're going to be talking about are just the things you know. I would like to thank Dr. Mofo for giving everyone a fair idea of how I think and the kinds of things I would like us to do to take the cause of our people forward. I always tell everybody, revolutions are about three things. One, the people. Two, the people. And three, the people. Revolutions have never been about leaders. It has never been about groups. It has never been about anything else. And if anyone tries to impress you that a revolution is connected to its leader, it is not true. Because in my study of revolutions around the world and in Africa, anything, and I repeat, anything the people want, they will always get it. If they want it badly enough, they will get it. And if you are pretending to be a leader, no matter what effort you put in, if the people are not ready to take what they want, it is a waste of time. I'm saying this to dismiss this whole fact about people speculating. Oh, why is he not taking leadership? Why is he leadership of what? What is there to take over? Can someone tell me? What is there to take over? We have a revolution in our hands. And one of the things I'm going to want this house tonight to do as a take home is that I've written a book entitled Wirba Force, The Force of Truth in Defense of Southern Cameroon. The reason is simple. It is the force of truth in defense of Southern Cameroon because Cameroon has lived a lie for 59 years, and the truth has had to be told. And part of that truth, I have told it in that book. When you have lived a lie, it's very easy. When I was in university, we had an American professor who used to tell us all the time, everybody has a right to dream. Yes or no? You have a right to dream that, you know, your personal car could actually be an helicopter. Yes. It's a dream. Some people dream and achieve it. But he warned us, if you dreamed that you bought a Rolls Royce, a black one, and then got up in the morning and started asking your neighbors who took your car, then there's something wrong. Then there is something wrong. Why am I saying this? I'm saying this because the people on the ground at home have put their blood to liberate us. And I have seen the rest of us out in the diaspora, and I mean you, gambling with their blood. It is unforgivable. It is never known. One of the things I'm going to give you a reference on is the opening page of the book we are presenting tonight has a one-line quotation from Hegel, a German philosopher, which goes, and I quote, "It is solely by risking life that freedom is obtained." End of quote. It is solely by risking life that freedom is obtained. That is the basis on which this book is written. So before you start asking other people what they have done, ask yourself, what have I risked? I have started listening to people asking, oh, we must not done this. We hear it in England. You don't say anything. You should force people to. I am not the kind that forces people to do things. I tell people just one thing, the truth. And if that truth is about you, there are people in this hall with whom we sacrifice our lives to build the SDF. And the only reason I have never been liked or loved was because I always tell the truth. I told the party in 1992, error number one, if you do not go in for parliamentary elections, the first nail on the party's coffin has been cheated in. They said, oh, no, don't listen to him, he's a bad man. If that party is struggling and is dying today and waiting for its burial, it half died in 1992 because it couldn't listen to a madman. As your government is struggling with a war that they will never win, it is not because they do not have the people who can tell them the facts as they are. As I said on the parliamentary floor, I have been going to their ministers and warning them and telling them that something is coming. We have to be careful. You don't mistreat people like this. Because in human evolution, there is always a turning point. When people reach that breakpoint, you never turn them back. Half of us can actually be killed in this process. But like I have established in the book, If the government of the Republic of Cameroon kills everybody and only the last child and that child's mother and their father are left, then those people will take the freedom that the rest of us die for. And that is what goes into freedom fighting. So before you start asking why the other people are not doing something, go back to Hegel again and find out that it is solely by risking life that freedom is obtained. And me talking to you, I have risked mine. Whether you believe it or not, I have risked mine. So when I have risked life to ask for your freedom, and you say you are waiting for me, what do you want me to bring to you? What is ready? What else? I've done my bit. Rather than hang out in the diaspora and lecture people back home, it is something I talk about very often, and my brother never likes it. Dr. Monfort, when I say there is something I'm beginning to learn, that there is a diaspora syndrome which seems to have infected almost everybody. And that syndrome tells you that immediately you leave us back home and fly somewhere else, like to England or to America, all the wisdom the people of this country have suddenly comes into you, and we who stay back home know nothing. That is the diaspora syndrome I have identified. And it is what is destroying this revolution. Because I challenge everybody. I said the decisions you started holding conferences and taking, give me three people, only three, out of the 7 or 8 million of us Southern Cameroonians that you people call to say, can we do this now, or what do you think about this? Because you travel to England, you now know more about the laws of physics than Einstein did, because you came to England on a visit. Because you went to the United States of America, all of a sudden, you can build a rocket to the moon because you live in America. It's not true. that everybody you left home knows so little is an insult. I'm saying this because I'm a living example. I find children, not even my third child's age, lecturing me on social media. Wirba should not do this. He should go and say this and do the other thing. And I'm saying, look at these kids. Do they know what they're talking about? All right. It is that wisdom that comes from the aeroplane. Yes. It's the wisdom that comes from the airplane. Immediately you fly in, you are gone. All right. And it is very, very destructive. So I listen to some of them talking, and I'm saying, oh my God, do they know what they're talking about? Because I know their parents, and some of us were talking about this struggle when we were still looking for their mothers to marry. Yes, and all of a sudden, this guy has become so wise, he can lecture and say, why shouldn't he do this? He should go and do the other thing. All right. Before anybody does that anymore, just ask yourself what you have risked. In terms of risk, let me tell you that if our revolution fails, Dr. Mofo, I want you to, you can quote me. If I die tonight, quote me. If this revolution fails, the diaspora will take 98.5% responsibility for its failure. You will take it directly. Why am I saying this? Revolutions work in every country because the diaspora chooses to do the revolution and not the politics of the revolution. You have chosen the politics. So there's no revolution anymore. Everybody is making calculations. You've chosen the politics instead of the revolution. Revolutions work because